Hi everyone, welcome back. And in the last class already we have seen what is an alphabet and what is a string and how to find the length of the string also. These all are basics about the formal language and automata theory. And see here, in the last class already I have given one important formula also, how to find the length of the string. See, if an alphabet contains two symbols, then you have to use 2 power n. 2 is nothing but total number of symbols in the given alphabet, and power of n. So what it indicates, n is nothing but length of the string. See, these are all points we have discussed in the last class, and now this is one more some basic definitions about the formal language and automata theory. That first topic is prefix. So how to find the prefix? See, any sequence of beginning symbols over the given string is called prefix. See, for example, see here, you can take any string, just like already I have given what is a string and what is an alphabet. String is nothing but sequence of symbols chosen from some alphabet. So alphabet may contains any symbols, and what is an alphabet? Finite and non-empty set of symbols is called an alphabet. Like that, already we have discussed all the basics. So based on that, if I will give you one string, then you have to find all the prefixes of the given string. So that's why this is the definition: any sequence of beginning symbols over the given string is called prefix. For the string, if you take TOC, TOC is nothing but this is a theory of computation. It is one of the subject, our subject only. Now we are talking formal language and automata theory, but previously the subject name is what? TOC, theory of computation. So you have to find prefixes for the given string. So what are the prefixes? All the beginning symbols you have to write. So beginning symbols starting empty string epsilon, by default you have to take. This is the basic prefixes. Why? Because if you take any number 10, then if you multiply 1 into 10, 10 only. The 1 is nothing but multiplicative additive. In the same way, in our subject, epsilon will also act as that multiplication, multiplicative addit. If you multiply any string with epsilon, you will get same string only. For example, epsilon into t equal to t only, epsilon into o equal to o only, epsilon into toc equal to toc only. Means if you multiply with any string, you will get same string. It will act as a multiplicative additive. So by default it is available. So for example, if I will give you one more example. For example, 10 plus 20 is there in mathematics. If you take 10 as a common, then we are writing 1 plus 2. Why we are writing 1? By default it is available. Why? Because in the mathematics, if you multiply 1 with any number, you will get same number. In the same way, epsilon is also available by default. That's why it is the basic prefix for any string, not only this string. For any given string, you have to write empty string epsilon as a common string. And already I told you, this is the zero length string also. In previous class already we have seen zero length string is what? Empty string epsilon. So that's why prefixes is nothing but you have to start with empty string epsilon. And for TOC, T is also one of the beginning symbol, that's why you can write T also. Then TO also we can write, and TOC also we can write. These all are beginning symbols. Beginning symbols, initial empty string epsilon, then you can take a one by one letter that will call as a string also. T, TO, TOC, but you should not take in different order. You have to take in sequence order only. From starting to ending, you have to go like this. You should not take like T and C, TC. You should not take like that. So it is not prefix. Is it clear? In prefixes, you have to take all the beginning symbols for any given string. So total 4 are possible: epsilon, T, TO, and TOC. Then in the same way, suffixes, this is totally opposite. Any sequence of ending symbols over the given string is called suffix. This is just like opposite to prefixes only. In prefixes we are starting from beginning, but in suffixes you have to start from ending. Same string I'm using, TOC. So how can you write for the string TOC? Suffixes are, so epsilon is common, that you have to take in anywhere. In 10 plus 20 already I told you 10 we are taking first, but if you take right side as a common 10, then epsilon plus, if you take right side common 10, then in the same way, TOC is nothing but suffixes we are taking. Suffixes means right side. So 10 plus 20, if I will give you one example, if you take 10, we can take 10 as a common either left side or right side. If you take right side, you have to write a 10. So 1 plus 2 into 10 In the same way, if you take TOC is nothing but ending symbols. That's why I'm telling right side common. So TOC, C is the right side common, C and OC and TOC from ending. The definition you remember, sequence of ending symbols. That's why you have to take ending symbols in the sequence order. C, OC and TOC. Epsilon is common for any given string. See, but here also you should not take C and T. C and T. Okay? C and T you have to take. You should not take in different order. You have to take in the sequence order only. Okay? And you can see these all are the example for the prefixes and suffixes. In the same way, I will explain substring also. These all are basic definitions only in our subject. If you know all the basics, then it is very easy for the next topic, so you can easily understand. And substring. What is a substring? Any sequence of symbols over the given string is called substring. So any sequence, previously prefixes, any sequence of beginning symbols we called, and in suffixes we are calling any sequence of ending symbols. But in substring, any sequence, I am not using beginning and ending term. You can simply call it as any sequence of symbols over the given string is called substring. So same string I am taking at TOC only. For the given string TOC, substrings are, we can write epsilon is common. So T is the one string and O is the one string, C is the one string, TO and OC and TOC. Like that we can write different types of substrings. Substrings, so many times already I hope you know this substrings in C language also. They will give you one string and find out the substring. Already you know about that, but here also you can remember substring is nothing but any sequence. Sequence you should maintain. Sequence is nothing but you should maintain sequence. If you take T and C, it is not in sequence order. That point you have to remember. You have to take all the strings in sequence order. That point you have to remember. I'm taking epsilon, T and O and C. Individually I am taking. If you want to take length with 2, TO and OC. TO and OC we can take, but we can't take T and C. So that sequence is violating. That's why I'm not taking TC. Is it clear? So that is a substring sequence of symbols. And TOC, same thing you have to write. In prefix and suffix and in substrings, what is the common point? Same string by default you have to write. So TOC is a, it will act as a prefix, it will act as a suffix, and it will also act as a substring. And proper prefix, already we have seen prefix, then what is the difference between prefix and proper prefix? Proper prefix, the definition you can see here, any prefix other than the given string is called proper prefix. See, total prefixes, just now we have seen total 4 prefixes are possible, prefixes I am talking, epsilon, T, TO and TOC. So except the given string, remaining all are called proper prefixes. You can see here epsilon, T, TO. And I am not using TOC. So if you remove TOC, same string I am removing. If you remove that one, then we can call it as proper prefix. That's why definition you can remember. Any prefix other than the given string. If you remove given string, then remaining strings are called proper prefixes. Called proper prefixes. Example for TOC, I have given example, you can see here. Epsilon, T, TO. But here, if you add TOC also, then we can call it as prefix only. If you remove TOC, then we can call it as proper prefix. In the same way, we can also, you can also find suffixes. Already I have given suffixes. So in the same way, you can find proper suffixes. If you remove given string, then we can call it as proper suffixes. So any suffix other than the given string is called proper suffix. Similar, just opposite only. See here. For TOC, proper suffixes are epsilon, C and OC. But I removed TOC. So TOC, same string I am not taking. So this is, if you remove given string, then we can call it as proper suffix. But here, if you add TOC also, then we can call it as all are suffixes. If you remove TOC, then we can call it as proper suffixes. So next one. Proper substring, in the same way proper substring also. Already we have seen substring definition, but in proper substring, any substring other than the given string is called proper substring. Any substring other than the given string is called proper substring. So first example, you can see example also. For TOC, proper substrings are epsilon, T O C T O and O C, but I removed T O C. If you add T O C, all are substrings only. If you remove T O C, it will called proper substring. So these all are basic definition. What is prefix and what is suffix and what is substring and what is proper prefix, what is proper suffix and proper substring. These all are basic definitions and very very important for our subject. Very very important. And you can practice, you can take one more string, our subject formal language and automata theory, flat. Flat you can take and you can find all the remaining, what is prefix for the flat, what is suffixes for the flat and what is the substring for the flat and what are the proper prefixes and proper suffixes and proper substrings for the string FLAT, that you have to find. See, already I have given one example for TOC, theory of computation, our subject name only, but your senior studies previously it is called as for R16 syllabus it is TOC, but now it is R18 syllabus, they changed name, flat, formal language and automata theory. You have to find all these prefixes, suffixes, all you have to find for the flat string. Is it clear? You have to find. And the next important definition, very very important, this one, language. So what is a language? A language is a set of strings. See, already I have given string definition, that's why I told you all definitions are very very important. What is an alphabet? What is a string? Again, for each and every definition, we have to use these terms only will come. A language is a set of strings chosen from given alphabet. Again, alphabet came. So, language is a set of strings chosen from given alphabet. See, example, see here. Language is nothing but simply you can remember, if you write set of strings, strings within a set, set of strings is nothing but if you write strings within a set, that is called a language. Is it clear? And why we are learning all these, what is alphabet, what is string, what is a language? Why? Because our subject is formal language and automata theory. What is automata? It is a mathematical model machine which is used to accept the language. So first you have to know about what is a language. So you can understand this language definition if you go through the previous topics, what is alphabet, what is a strings, all are covering here. Then only you will know about language. A language is a set of strings chosen from given alphabet. So these all languages are accepted by the finite automata model. Finite automata. Is it clear? So language definition, again I am repeating, set of strings chosen from given alphabet. See here, I have given one alphabet A comma B. This is the one alphabet. And we can form different types of languages. The following are various languages formed from the given alphabet A comma B, A comma B only. See here, first language L1 is nothing but a language 1. Set of all strings of length 0. I have given one statement, but equivalent language also you have to write. I am writing only one string. Already I told you empty string. Epsilon is the special case. If you are talking about a length 0 means you have to remember it is empty string epsilon. If you write empty string epsilon within a set, it is also a one of the language. So set of all strings of length 0, only one string is possible, that is empty string epsilon only. Then next, one more example, set of all strings of length 1 over the given alphabet A comma B only. Alphabet is always A comma B. From the given alphabet only I am finding all the languages. Set of all strings of length 1. Length 1 means A is the one string. So what is the length of A? 1 only. And B is also a one more string. So what is the length of B? 1 only. So set of all strings of length 1, only A comma B, only two strings are possible with length 1. We can't write other strings with length 1. One more example, that language 3. See here, if I will give you one statement, you have to write those corresponding strings also. Set of all strings of length 2. Set of all strings of length 2 means each and every string length should be 2. So if you write all the strings with length 2 within a set, then that is also we can call it as a language. Why? Because what is the language definition? A language is a set of strings chosen from given alphabet only. So set of all strings of length 2, AA, AB, BA, BB. Only 4 are possible, we can't write others. And see here, no need to write all the possibilities. See, what is the question set of all strings of all strings I am asking, that's why AA, AB, BA, BB I am writing. So based on the statement only it will change. For example, write a set of some strings of length 2. Some string means no need to write 4, you can write either 1 or 2 or 3. One string or two string or three strings or four strings with length 2. For example, AA, set of strong string, if I will, that is depending on the statement only. If I will mention set of all strings means you have to write all the possibilities with length 2. If I will mention some strings means you can write any two only. Either AA or AB or BA or BB. Sometimes I will change that statement. Set of all strings of length 2 which are starting with A. In that case you have to write only AA and AB. You should not write BA. Why? Because it is starting with B. So that's why the language you have to write based on that statement also you have to write. For example, one more example here I am giving. Set of all strings of length 2 which are starting with B. Which are starting with B means you can see total 4 possibilities are there, AA, AB, BA, BB. But AA and AB are not starting with B. So we can remove this first 2. We have to write only BA and BB. Like that the question may be they will ask in different ways. For example, write a set of all strings of length 2 which are ending with B. Which are ending with B means you have to write only AB and BB only. You should not write AA and BA. Is it clear? Based on the statement you have to write all the strings. Like that for any given question, the based on the statement you have to write all the strings within the set. And see here fourth example for the language, empty language. So you should not write any symbol. Even you should not write empty string epsilon also. Why? Because empty string epsilon is having length 1. But here empty language, what is symbol 1 but length 0 only for empty string epsilon. But empty language is total different. It should not contain any string. Even you should not write empty string epsilon also. This is called empty language. It is, you should not write any symbol. The language should be empty. But the alphabet definition I have given, the alphabet should not be empty. What is the alphabet definition? Basic definitions already I told you, basic definitions are very very important. Alphabet is nothing but finite, non-empty. Alphabet is non-empty, but the language may be empty. Empty language, it is denoted with empty set phi. This is called as phi symbol. And always you remember, empty language is the always minimum language. If you take any alphabet, you can form any language, we can form any languages. The language may be finite or infinite, but always the minimum language is always empty set phi. Minimum language, always you remember, the minimum language is always empty set phi. And the fifth example you can see here, epsilon a comma b, aa, ab, ba, bb, 3as, aab, it is infinite. So the language may be infinite also. The language may be empty and the language may be infinite. But alphabet definition I have given, it should be finite and non-empty. This is total different languages. It may be empty and it may be infinite also. And this infinite language we can call it as universal language. Why we are calling it as universal language? See here, empty string epsilon, it is zero length. And a comma b is nothing but this is length 1. AA, AB, BA, BB is nothing but length 2. After that length 3. Infinite means you can take either length 4, length 5, length 6, like that infinite. That's why it is called as universal language. You have to take all the possibilities with length 0, length 1, length 2, length 3. This language is called universal language. These two are very very important. Minimum language is empty set 5. And maximum language is you have to write all the strings with all length, including 0 length, 1 length, 2 length. This language is called universal language. And one more example here I am giving. If the input alphabet equal to 0 comma 1 and language I have given, set of all strings containing even number of zeros. I have given one statement, you have to write corresponding language. What is the question I have given? Input alphabet is 0 comma 1. You have to use only zeros and ones only. But question is what? Set of all strings containing even number of zeros. So even number of zeros, you can take epsilon. Epsilon means what? Zero. Zero number of zeros. So it is, zero is also one even number. So zero number of zeros you have to write. So empty string epsilon is a zero number of zeros. Then you can take, what is the next even number? Two. So two number of zeros. So I have written two number of zeros according to question. Set of all strings containing even number of zeros. In the same way, 4 number of zeros. 4 is also even number. So 4 zeros you have to write. You should not write 5 zeros. Why? Because 5 is not a even number. 6 number of zeros. 8 number of zeros. So it is an infinite language. Infinite. Even numbers are infinite. So like that, infinite. So it languages may be, it may be infinite. So in the same way, you can write, I will give you one more question. Set of all strings containing odd number of ones. For this, you have to write answer. I have given one statement. Over the given alphabet, 0, 1 only. Input alphabet, 0, 1. And you have to write, set of all strings containing odd number of ones. Then I will give you 1 minute time, then you can write. And this is the answer. You should not write empty string epsilon. Why? Because that is zero number. So odd numbers are nothing but one only. So one number of ones. Next, three number of ones. Five number of ones. Seven number of ones. Like that, infinite. You have to write odd number of ones. Odd number of ones like this. One number of ones. Three number of ones. Five number of ones. Seven number of ones. This is the example for the given language. This is a perfect language for odd number of ones. Over the given alphabet 0, 1. They are asking about ones only. That's why I have written ones only. Okay, and these are some examples of power of an alphabet. You can see here, if an input alphabet A, B, then length sigma power 0 is nothing but length with 0. Sigma power 1 is nothing but length with 1. Sigma power 2 is nothing but length with 2. So I have given some example. Set of all strings over the given alphabet of length 0 is nothing but length 0 is always empty string epsilon. Length 1 means A comma B. Length 2 means AA, AB, BA, BB. So mod is nothing but how many strings are possible with length 2. Sigma power is 2 is nothing but what? How many strings are possible with length 2. Power is indicates length with 2. Mod is nothing but total number of strings are possible. Total 4. See here AA, AB, BA, BB. Length with 2, total 4 possibilities are there. So that's why 4. And similarly, sigma power 3 is nothing but set of all strings are with length 3. Length 3 means 2 cube equal to 8. Like that you have to find. Is it clear? Okay, thank you.